Well, there's one kind of favor I'll ask of you. Well, there's one kind of favor I'll ask of you. There's just one kind of favor I'll ask of you. You can't see that my grave's kept clean.
I think what scares people about cemeteries is the quiet. They're so dead. I always imagined I'd end up here one day. In the ground, I'd be like the vegetable scraps I dump in the compost. In transition. An ugly phase before becoming soil. But then, I did a little digging. I learned that death used to be simpler. Your family would put you in a casket and put you in the ground. Now, there's more to organize.
We need to register the death, transfer the individual from the hospital where the death has occurred, transfer them to either a cemetery plot or a crematorium. Some families will say, we're just going to have the service. It has the same components, but there's additional add-ons. The wood casket itself can be of different sizes and species of wood. The protective casket is a steel casket, just got a rubber gasket that goes around it, and it doesn't let any of the earthly elements after it's locked and sealed into the casket.
It was when we went to the funeral home, and it was everything was so depressing and neo-Gothic and overpriced and weird and creepy. And did I say overpriced? I'm going to say it again.
I still remember seeing my grandfather in his casket when I was a 7-year-old kid. And this was this tough Italian immigrant who grew his own vegetables and made his own salami. But I thought, whose idea was it to put makeup on this guy? Why are we trying to deny what is such a natural process?
Death and death rituals became a focus for Paula's work.
I know that even in what you would think would be liberal circles of artists, that often if I say that I'm working as an artist in residence at a cemetery or doing research around death, people get a little, ooh. I had initially thought that I wanted to be cremated because I thought that that was the least impact, and also because I thought that there was never going to be a place that I could afford to be buried.
It's a simple process. The body is put into the cremation chamber where it will stay for between 3 and 5 hours. It will be subjected to heat and fire, to temperatures ranging between 6 and 900 degrees Celsius. One cremation uses enough natural gas to heat the average Canadian home for 10 days. If there's no space to put bodies in the ground, then cremation makes sense. But what do we have in this country if not space? I'm told our cemeteries are full. Or getting there. On this continent, they operate on a one body per grave basis, and graves are lined with plastic or concrete.
Now, historically around the world, I mean, green burial has been done, and it's been done for some pragmatic reasons. Oftentimes in cemeteries in Europe, for example, graves are recycled, and you want bodies to decompose.
If a cross was rotting, that meant it was time for the local gravedigger to get to work. He'd take what was left of a body and bring it to the local ossuary. A new body would be put in the grave to decompose.
Conventional death care for the last century plus has been about impeding that natural process and making people feel that it's the decent and sanitary thing to do. In reality, when you put a box in a box in the ground in chemicals in the body, you force it to have to deal with anaerobic bacteria. There's putrefaction, there's liquefying of tissues. And when you have a green burial, you have, I think, a gentler and more quicker kind of decomposition. But, you know, there's not a pretty way of describing that process.
In the woodland section at Royal Oak Burial Park in Victoria, bodies are buried at a depth of 1.2 meters to maximize decomposition. The remains are not embalmed and caskets are optional. Eventually, this space will be indistinguishable from the surrounding forest.
To me, green burial is returning to the earth for real, not symbolically, not in a concrete liner and a hermetically sealed casket that will separate me forever, like forever, from the earth. Actually laying me down in the earth and being reabsorbed and feeding the planet. And I had imagined that I'd like to be buried with an apple tree planted above me so that I could feed my great-grandchildren.
Paula Jardine knows what she wants for her body, and she's found a place where that burial can happen. She won't tell me where, though. Royal Oak in Victoria is technically the only place in Canada where that kind of burial is possible. So for most of us, that's not an option. Most of us would rather avoid the subject altogether. But if we do, the decision will be made for us. Me, I want to go to the worms. I just have to figure out how to make that happen. And my hands turn cold. And my heart stopped beating and my hands turned cold. Now I believe what the Bible told. There's just one last favor I'll ask you. And there's one last favor I'll ask you. There's just one last favor I'll ask of you. See that my grave is kept clean.